change your heart, change your life, change the planet.
Hey everybody, it's Tim Van Orden, and I just witnessed something truly extraordinary. Eliud Kipchoge broke 2 hours in the marathon, running 1 hour, 59 minutes, and 40 seconds. First person in history to go sub-2 in the marathon. And as much as that is an incredible accomplishment, I'm a little confused as much as I'm excited, and I'm also concerned. I've got some questions, so I want to present them here in this video and talk about the place that we're at in 2019 with athletics and performance enhancement and corporate branding or corporate leveraging of athletes. But before we get into that, I want to say that in no way am I trying to take away from Eliud Kipchoge's accomplishment today. What he did is truly extraordinary. That just blows my mind. He ran sub-4:38 per mile for a marathon. If I were to run a single 4:38 mile, I would break my own American record for 50-plus road mile by 8 seconds. It's incredible what he did. And if you don't understand how fast that is, go to your local track and run a 69-second lap, and then keep doing it over and over and over again until you've run a marathon. That's incredible. But here's where it gets a little interesting. One of the things that the commentators were saying in this event was, we put a man on the moon, and now we've got a man who ran a sub-2-hour marathon. And they're both true. But if we look at it, Neil Armstrong didn't put himself on the moon. Neil Armstrong had a huge team of who knows how many people helping him to be the first person on the moon. Now, he had to go through some extraordinary training to get into NASA and then to qualify for the moon mission and then to actually go through with it all. I don't want to take that away from him. But Neil Armstrong did not put himself on the moon. And Eliud Kipchoge did not put himself sub-2 hours in the marathon. So let's look at what they did today as a team, as a corporate effort to help him get under 2 hours. Number one, Nike has pretty much reinvented the shoe. In 2018, when Eliud tried for the first time to break the marathon record and go under 2 hours, they designed a new shoe called the 4%, which was supposed to give you 4% more energy per stride, and therefore to go from the current world record, shave 4%, and now you're suddenly under 2 hours. Well, they've improved the shoes since then. So number one, he's got enhanced running shoes that you cannot just go out and buy. They're made specifically for him. Number two, he had a team of engineers, and when I say he, this group, this organization, had engineers working on the aerodynamics of the formation of athletes in front of and behind him. I'm sure they did all kinds of wind tunnels and modeling, and they figured out that having two athletes in front, two on the side, one directly in front of him, and then two behind him was the most aerodynamic position for a runner and would reduce drag the most. So he would actually have to do less work than if he was running all by himself. So we've got shoes supposedly reducing his effort by 4%. We've got the group of runners running with him, designed by a team of engineers to reduce his effort. Then we've got somebody on a bicycle feeding him nutrition, giving him water. He doesn't have to stop at a water stop. He's right there, never breaks his stride, and he's got someone giving him what he needs as he goes. Also, there's a car in front of them showing a laser beam on the road, and that laser beam is the 2 hour mark. So if they can stay with that laser beam, they will run 2 hours. If they can surpass it, they'll break 2 hours. And additionally, the pacers that were working with him, they kept changing. So they were always fresh. None of them were lagging. None of them were going to put in a surge. None of them were trying to win the race. They were trying to keep him at a consistent pace. So I'm not saying that mentally this was any easier, but clearly physically it was designed to be much easier than an individual running a marathon in race conditions. So it's not record eligible for several reasons. Number one, because someone gave him nutrition and he didn't have to pull over. Number two, because he was the only person in the event. There were no other athletes. And number three, because of the number of pacers that kept swapping and changing positions. So they always had a fresh group to work with. So it's not a record eligible time. It is not the world marathon record. It is a publicity stunt. And it's a very well orchestrated publicity stunt. You've got everybody in the world almost tuning into this. My mom this morning said, "Oh my God, somebody broke 2 hours in the marathon." She doesn't even know what that means, and yet she's talking about it because it's all over the news. But here's where it gets really, really tricky. Last week, Alberto Salazar, one of the world's best coaches, was banned from coaching for 4 years due to doping violations. It is alleged that he was giving his athletes banned substances. So we have one of the world's best coaches getting a 4-year ban because he was engaging in practices that enhanced his athletes' performance. And then over here, you have someone running sub 2 hours in the marathon quite publicly employing methods that enhanced performance. So the question before us today is, as an audience, would we rather see athletes using every means possible and available, along with corporate sponsorship and muscle, achieve things like a sub 2-hour marathon? Or do we want to go back to the days of amateur athletics where it was you as an individual doing what you could, working your butt off on a level playing field, hopefully with everybody else, and achieving something extraordinary without a massive research and development budget and all kinds of tools that enhance your human performance? Or should I say, enhance what is possible for a human being to do? We're celebrating Eliud Kipchoge using performance-enhancing external tactics, and we're banning Alberto Salazar for using performance-enhancing pharmaceutical interventions. So do we want to see people cheating or not? Which one is it? Now, Eliud Kipchoge's world record in the marathon is 2 hours, 1 minute, and 39 seconds. So unaided, unenhanced, he's only a minute and 39 seconds away. But why not give him a chance to get down below the 2-hour mark without all that performance enhancement? And then you've got Kenenisa Bekele, who just ran 2 hours, 1 minute, and 41 seconds. He just missed Kipchoge's world record by 2 seconds. Now, why was he not included? Why wasn't he part of this? He's obviously in the same level of fitness as Eliud Kipchoge, but didn't have this massive corporate movement or team behind him. So it gave Eliud what I consider to be an incredibly unfair advantage. So the question to you, do we want to see athletes enhanced? Do we want to see the fastest cyclists in the world doping and out-competing each other, not because one was doping and the others were clean, but because they're all doping and one of them was the best of the dopers because they work the hardest? Or do we want to see nobody doping? Do we want to stop enhancements in shoes and other technologies like track surfaces? Do we want to go back to like stock cars in NASCAR where every car has to be the same? So I find this to be a really interesting moment in running history, if not sport history, due to the fact that the Alberto Salazar ban is happening just a week before Kipchoge's sub 2-hour performance. Now, Eliud Kipchoge broke 2 hours, clearly using performance-enhancing technologies. Now, is he to blame for that? He went along with it. He agreed to it. And it's not a world record performance. It wasn't the Olympics. It wasn't a world championship. It was a publicity event. So hopefully everybody is clear on that. But is that what the public wants? Would the public rather have these gigantic publicity events, or would they rather have athletes working really hard without all that scaffolding and seeing what's possible there? Seeing what's possible when Eliud Kipchoge goes head-to-head with Kenenisa Bekele in a marathon. I want to see that. Now, is that going to happen in the near future? I don't know. But would they be able to run 248 to 252 per kilometer if they went head-to-head? Or would somebody throw in a surge Would they be running 3 minutes per kilometer to try to feel each other out and see what's going on? And then suddenly somebody's running a 240 or 230 kilometer. It would be a really interesting race and very, very different than what we saw today. So in real world conditions, I don't know if those two would break 2 hours. They may break each other. But that's something that makes sport worth watching to me. Seeing people in the midst of uncertainty, in the midst of the unknown, and working with other people who do not have their best interest in mind. So those are my thoughts. I really don't know what to think about this, other than the fact that this was a performance-enhanced publicity event, and yes, it's extraordinary, but at the same time, what does it mean for the future of running? What will fans demand? What will companies demand? And how is it going to affect the average person that can't afford a gigantic team like Eliud Kipchoge had today? Is it fair for everybody else? Or have we moved into the era of elite corporate running? I don't know. What are your thoughts? Leave them in the comments below.